नमस्ते स्टूडेंट्स, खुश रहो बिटिया। आई एम जेबीन डॉक्टर अजीज मोहम्मद खान फ्रॉम डिपार्टमेंट ऑफ फूड एंड बायोटेक्नोलॉजी, फैकल्टी ऑफ एग्रीकल्चर एंड वेटरनरी साइंस, ज्योति विद्यापीठ वुमेंस यूनिवर्सिटी। टुडे आई एम गोइंग टू डिस्कस अबाउट द किंगडम ऑफ माइक्रो ऑर्गेनिजम्स, डिफरेंट काइंड ऑफ किंगडम एंड क्लासिफिकेशन ऑफ माइक्रो ऑर्गेनिज्म। So according to Whitaker, there are five kingdoms which were proposed. In the previous video, we discussed about introduction of microbiology and microorganism. And in this video, we will discuss about the classification of microorganism. And according to Whitaker, there are five kingdoms. There are Monera, Protista, Fungi, Plantae, and Animalia. In the kingdom Monera, only the simplest type of microorganisms are added. What is the meaning of the simple? Simple means these organisms are not complex in structure, they are simple because they have a single cell. So these organisms are added in the Monera. The example is bacteria and archaea. These bacteria, archaea have a single cell, and all the functions of body, all the function of the organism is conducted by a single cell. So they are very simple, and due to this simplicity they are added in the Monera. Protista, in the Protista, single and multicelled organism are added, including algae and protozoa. In the fungi, mold, lichens and yeast are added. In the Plantae, a multicellular photosynthetic organism are added, including plants. And in the Animalia, animals are added in the Animalia kingdom. First, we will discuss about the kingdom Monera. What are the characteristics of the kingdom Monera? The members of the Monera have single cell, and they have no true nucleus, means the nucleus do not have any surrounding membrane. So their genetic material, that is their DNA, RNA, it's not enclosed in a membrane, it is naked. So they are also known as prokaryotic organism. Some of the members of the kingdom Monera have the ability to move because they have a specific organelle, that is flagellum. But some of the organism cannot move due to absence of this flagellum. And the member of the kingdom Monera can make their own food, means they are autotrophic. And some of the organisms of the Monera are dependent on some other organisms, or they are dependent on some other kind of raw material and dead animals. So they are known as the heterotrophic. The examples include bacteria, blue-green bacteria, that are cyanobacteria. The next kingdom is kingdom Protista. Kingdom Protista is also simple like Monera because they also have a single cell. But what is the difference? They have a true nucleus, means they have a membrane around their DNA or RNA. Their genetic material is surrounded by a nuclear layer. and similarly they can some of them can move and some of them cannot due to presence of cilia, flagella and pseudopodia. And some of the organisms are autotrophic and some of them are heterotrophic, means they are dependent on some other types of organism. And the examples of kingdom Protista include the amoeba, diatom, Eubiana, paramecium and algae, which are unicellular. Now the kingdom fungi. Fungi are multicellular. They are not single cellular. And these fungi are included in the kingdom eukaryotes. They have three nucleus, and the nucleus is surrounded by a membrane, and they cannot move from one place to another, and their reproduction is by some budding methods, and they are dependent on some dead materials for their food. And the examples include mushroom. The mushroom is autotrophic in the nutrition. Some other organisms include mold, puffballs, bracket fungus, and yeast. Yeast is also included in the kingdom fungi. The other kingdom are plantae, which includes plants. They are multicellular, have two nucleus, so they cannot move, autotrophic, and they are multicellular, very well balanced. And the highest complex organisms are animalia, which are multicellular, have two nucleus, they can move, they are heterotrophic in nature, and examples include man, bird, frog, fish. So these are the examples of the kingdom Animalia. What is the classification pattern? The classification pattern is first kingdom, means Monera, then phylum, then class, then order, then family, then genus, and last is species. There are two types of cells. Prokaryote and eukaryote. So first, the cell is the simple basic unit of life, and that is the fundamental of living unit. And on the basis of the cellular structure, there are two organisms, prokaryotic and eukaryotes. And the microbes are both prokaryotes and eukaryotes. And viruses are composed only of a few genes. And the structure of prokaryote and eukaryote is demonstrated in this diagram that we will discuss in another video also and another lectures. This is the genetic material of the prokaryote and the genetic material of eukaryotes, that is surrounded by a layer. That is the major difference. What are the organisms which are included in the microbes? The first one is bacteria. Bacteria are unicellular. The simplest organism are bacteria. And they do not have, as we know that they are added in the prokaryotes, because they do not have any particular cell membrane. So they are included in this bacteria. The three major basic shapes of bacteria are bacillus, coccus and spiral. So these are the basic shapes of the bacteria, that is rods, spirochetes, coccus. Okay, if there are two cocci, coccus bacteria are there, then it is known as the diplococcus, and there are more coccus bacteria in a chain, then they are known as the streptococci, and if they are in a bunch, then they are known as the staphylococci, but if they are in a tetra, then they are known as the tetras. So diplococci, streptococci, staphylococci and tetrads. If the roots and one coccus mix together, then they are known as the coccobacilli, and the another cell is vibrio, that is common cell. And spirochetes are spiral in nature. So this is the shape of the bacteria. The bacteria have a peptidoglycan cell wall, and they divide by binary fission method, and some of them contain flagella for the movement. In the kingdom fungi, they are included in the eukaryotes, and most are multicellular in their structure. Fungi obtain their nutrients by absorbing organic matter from the environment. The next organism that is included in the microorganism is protozoa. Protozoa are unicellular, and they are in eukaryotes. They are in eukaryotes, and they have two nucleus, and they obtain their nourishment by absorbing or ingestion through the and their structures. Next is algae. Algae is also included in the kingdom protozoa, and the algae are unicellular or multicellular, both. They are eukaryotes, and algae produce oxygen and carbohydrates that are used by other organisms. The example is blue green algae is the example, green algae, red algae. These are the examples of the algae. Viruses are non-cellular structures, and they are parasites of other cells. Viruses are very small structure that they do not have any cellular structure. They do not have any cell. They have their genetic material, and due to their genetic material, they can multiply in other organisms. They can insert their genetic material, that is their DNA, RNA. They can infect to another microbes, as well as they can infect human beings, animals. So they are the smallest unit of living organism. And the genetic material of viruses is surrounded by protein coat, and an envelope may surround the coat also. So this is the genetic material of bacteria, and it is a structure of bacterial cell wall that we will discuss in another video. So our video is over here. Thank you very much.